Now let us discuss about normed and Banach algebras. So before going into the details about what is a normed algebra or what is a Banach algebra, let us first understand what an algebra is. So an algebra, this is another algebraic structure which is defined on field K. So we denote the algebra by A, the corresponding field by K. So what is that? That is a vector space over K such that if you take any two elements from that space A, then you get a unique product XY, which is also present in that algebra or that set or that space and has the following properties. Now the first property here, it gave you the associativity between the three elements taken from A. The second and third property, they give you the distributive property, where and for the fourth property we have scalar as alpha. So all these four conditions should be satisfied in addition to A being a vector space over the field K. If everything is satisfied in this way, we say A is an algebra over the field K. So a simple example of algebra is the set consisting of all linear operators which are defined on a vector space into itself. So that is algebra. So here we note that if your field, the associated field, that is the real field or complex field, then according to your algebra would also be real algebra or complex algebra. That is quite obvious. Next we see that we may also say an algebra to be commutative or abelian if the multiplication is commutative. That means if you take any two elements from that algebra, then the condition xy is equal to yx should hold. And next we call an algebra with identity if that algebra contains an element e such that this element is the identity element, and such that for every element present in that algebra we have ex is equal to x, e is equal to x. So this is the requirement. So moreover, you should note that the element e, that is the identity of the algebra, that has to be unique. This is very easy to prove, so you may try this one. Next, let us see what is a normed algebra. So a normed algebra is again an algebra such that in this way we have a norm associated with it. So this normed algebra, instead of defining this on a vector space, we define it on the normed space such that for every two elements present in this algebra, this result holds. Now you should make it a point to memorize this property. This property says you have the norm of xy less than equal to norm of x and norm of y. So if this property holds, then only you can say that the algebra which is defined on the normed space is a normed algebra. And moreover, if this algebra has identity, in that case the norm of that identity has to be equal to 1. So this is the condition for normed algebra. And in a similar manner, we may also define a Banach algebra. So you might have guessed until now what is a Banach algebra. Banach algebra is now defined a normed space which is complete. So that means it would be defined on a Banach space. So a normed algebra which is complete is considered as a Banach algebra whenever we are taking the space to be the normed space. Right. So let's see examples concerning this normed algebra and Banach algebra. So we say the real line R and the complex plane C, they are commutative Banach algebras with identity E is equal to 1. Right? So this is very trivial examples. The real line and the complex plane, both of them are Banach algebras, and in fact every element there commutes, and also it has an identity which is equal to 1. Next, the space C closed interval AB. What is this space? This space consists of all the functions defined over the closed interval AB such that the functions are continuously differentiable. So this space is a commutative Banach algebra with identity E is equal to 1. Because you have already studied about this space, this space is norm space, right, accordingly, which is complete. So we can define the Banach algebra in this way, and this is also commutative. The product xy in this case is defined like this. So xy defined in the independent variable t. Now where this independent variable comes from? It come from the closed interval AB. So this is defined as x of t, y of t. And moreover, the subspace consisting of all the polynomials, that is a commutative normed algebra. So whole of the space, that is commutative Banach algebra. However, the subspace which consists only of the polynomial functions, polynomials, so we say that to be commutative normed algebra. Right. So moving on to next example, we have another vector space X consisting of all complex n cross n matrix. So now the elements of the vector space, they are complex matrices, complex square matrices which are defined, and the order is fixed. So in that case, that space is non-commutative algebra with identity capital I. Now what is this capital I? It is the identity matrix. And we define a norm on X, we obtain a Banach algebra. What is this? This is non-commutative algebra. Why non-commutative? Because you see that matrices do not commute with each other. And moreover, if you associate a norm corresponding to this algebra, you will have a Banach algebra from that same space. Now talking about operators, our next example is based on the bounded linear space consisting of all the linear operators which are bounded and are defined on the space X. So we say this is a Banach space, right, and it is defined on the complex Banach space. This is a Banach algebra. And in this case, the identity of this Banach algebra is simply the identity operator. So, how do we define multiplication in this case? The multiplication is defined by the way of defining norms. So, it is the norm of T1, T2, which is less than equal to norm of T1, norm of T2. However, this bounded set of all linear operators, this is not commutative until and unless the dimension of the space is equal to 1. Right? So this is the example that we have with us. So this is how we define the algebras, normed algebras, and the Banach algebras.